टू प्लस प्रेजेंट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब आई यू फाइंड ए प्रेजेंट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब आफ्टर टू इट इज कॉल्ड एन इंफिनिटिव इट इज कॉल्ड एन इंफिनिटिव व्हेन यू फाइंड टू देन प्रेजेंट फॉर्म इट इज कॉल्ड एन इंफिनिटिव एन इंफिनिटिव रेफर्स और एन इंफिनिटिव सजेस्ट्स द पर्पस ऑफ ए सब्जेक्ट एन इंफिनिटिव सजेस्ट्स The purpose of a subject in a sentence. The purpose of a subject in a sentence. For example, I have come here to teach you English. I have come here to teach you English. What is my purpose? My purpose is to teach you. My purpose is to teach. Here is the purpose of the subject. So infinitive directs or suggests the purpose of the sentence. So when you find a gap after to, you will write a present form. When you find a gap after to, you will write a present form of the verb. Next point is other prepositions plus verb plus ing. We know to is a preposition. And other prepositions are in, for, with, without, from, into, etc. So when you find a gap after other prepositions, where you will add ing with the verb. If you find a gap after preposition, then you will add ing with the base form of the verb. For example, you come to college for learning. For learning. Why it is learning? Because there is for here. So for and other prepositions like in, into, after, before, you will add ing with the base form of the verb. As an example, I am busy in making notes. Why making? Because it is here. So after it, you will add ing with the base form of the verb. I repeat the two points again. When you find a gap after to, you will write a present form. Only a present form. No s by s, no ing. You write only a present form of the verb. And when you find a gap after other prepositions, then you will add ing with the base form of the verb. I think you have understood the two points. Next point is modal verb plus present form of verb. Modal verb. We know modal verbs are shall, will, should, would, can, could, may, might, must. These are modal verbs. If you find a gap after modal verb, then you will write a present form of the verb. When you find a gap after modal verb, then you will write present form of the verb. And you should read attentively. You should read attentively. Here is present form. Because there is a modal verb here. As an example, he must come here. He must come here. We find come. It is present form. Because must is here. Must is a modal verb. So it is present form. So after modal verbs, you will write a present form of the verb. Next point is modal verb plus be plus VPP. That means verb past participle. When you find modal verb, then be, then you will write the verb in past participle form. For example, the work should be done. The work should be done. Should, modal verb, be, so past participle. If you find modal verb, then gap, you will write only the present form of the verb. But when you find modal verb, then be, then gap, then you will write past participle in the gap. I again repeat the point, if you find a gap after only a modal verb, then you will write the present form of the verb. But when you find modal verb, then be, then gap, then you will write verb PP. That means you will write past participle. participle in the game. I think you have understood the two points. Next, I will discuss do, does, did, let, but plus present form of verb. Do, does, did, let, but plus present form of verb. For example, he does not help the poor. He does not help the poor. See, here help, not helps. Though it is negative sentence, but we find present form after does. So when you find a gap after do, does, did, let, but, you will write a present form of the verb. Another example, let me do the work. Let me do the work. See, here is present form. Let, then an object, then present form. So when you find do, does, did, let, but, we will write a present form in the gap. I will move to the next point. Had better, had rather, would better, would rather, plus present form of the verb. Had better, had rather, would better, would rather, plus present form of verb. For example, you had better go home. See, go, not goes, not going. Go, that means present form. You will write present form after had better, would better, and would rather. Another example, he would rather die than beg. See, die, present form. So, after would rather, he will write present form of the verb. So, when you find had rather, would better, would rather, and then again, you will write, of course, a present form of the verb in the game.
Next point is number 7. Stop, stir, help, mind, while, begin, see, average, plus, verb plus ing. I think it is one of the important points. Stop, stir, help, mind, while, begin, see, average, plus, verb plus ing. For example, stop writing. Stop writing. If you write, stop write, then it is wrong. You have to write writing. So stop writing, stop talking, stop doing the work, stop polluting water. So after stop, you will write a present participle. That means verb plus ing. Start reading. Start jumping. Start talking. I cannot help going there. Help and win. So after help, you will add ing with the present form of the verb. So if you find a gap, after help, you will write present participle. Would you mind opening the window? Would you mind opening the window? It is a request. Open. Would you mind opening the window? Would you mind coming here? Would you mind giving me a pen? So, you will add ing with the verbs when you find a gap after these words. I think you have understood the point. Next point is the rules of past participle. The simple 7 rules I will show you of making past participle when we do past participle. The first one, BPP plus by. If you find a verb before a by, then you will write the verb in past participle form. I repeat, when you find a gap before a by, then you will write the verb in past participle form. Then being plus BPP. After being, you will write past participle form. To be plus BPP. To have plus BPP, get got getting plus BPP, have had having plus BPP, and moreover plus B plus BPP. I have discussed earlier this point. So there are 7 tips for making past participle of the verb in a sentence.
For example, rice is eaten by me. Look, before by, if you have a verb, if you get a verb before by, then you will write the verb in past participle form. Another example, water is being polluted. If you find a verb after being, then you will make the verb in past participle form. I got the rice cooked. Got, cooked. If you find a verb after got, then you will get, got, getting. Then you will make the verb in past participle form. The problem needs to be solved. To be. Then, BPP. That means past participle form. So, I showed you 7 tips for making verb past participle. I think it will help you greatly. But there is an exception here. If by means beside. By means beside. When you get by and it means beside, then the previous rule, it does not apply. We cannot apply this rule. If by means beside, then we cannot write past participle before by. Then we will write the verb according to the subject and according to the tense. That means when by means beside, then we will not write the past participle form before by. Then we will write the verb according to the subject and according to the tense. For example, he sits by me. That means he sits by me, side by side. He sits by me. We will not write past participle here. Dhaka stands by the Buriyonga. Dhaka Buriyonga. That is side by side. So I write here in present indefinite tense. I will stand by you in future. I will stand by you in future. So I write the verb here in future indefinite tense. So when by means side by side, beside, then we will not make the verb past participle before by. I think you have understood the point.
Next point is, if you find the subject of the sentence is lifeless, that means there is no life in the subject of the sentence. It is a lifeless object. When you find that, for example, duster, table, fair, they are lifeless. A duster is lifeless. So when you find a lifeless object in the position of a subject, then you will make the sentence in passive. When you find a lifeless subject, you will make the sentence in passive form. Because a lifeless thing cannot do anything actively. When the subject cannot do anything actively, you will make the sentence in passive form. And when the subject can do everything actively, then you will make the sentence in active voice. So, look at the example. Water is polluted in many ways. Water is polluted. That means people pollute water. People actively pollute water. But we find water in the position of the subject. Whether people should be subject. But don't find people in the position of the subject. We find water in the position of the subject. Water is lifeless and it is polluted. So the sentence is in passive form. Is in passive form. When you find past participle after any verb, you can clearly say that it is a passive voice. When you find past participle after any verb, then you will clearly say that it is in passive form. So the sentence is in passive form because the subject is lifeless. Water here cannot do anything. Next, computer is used in offices. Who use computer? People use computer. But people is not here. On the other hand, computer is in the position of the subject. So the sentence is in passive form. Computer is used. It is in present indefinite tense in passive form. Is used. Well, so when you find a lifeless object in the position of a subject, you will write the sentence in passive form. But when the lifeless subject works actively, the subject is lifeless, but it works actively, then you will make the sentence in active voice. For example, fire burns everything. We know there is no life in fire. There is no life in fire, but it can burn many things. So here, fire burns everything. Fire subject works actively. So I write the sentence in active voice. When you find the sentences according to the structure of the tense, then you will say that the sentence is in active voice. When you find the sentence according to the structure of the tense, then you will say that the sentence is in active voice. So the sentence is in present indefinite tense. The sentence follows the structure of the present indefinite tense. So the sentence is active voice. Why active? Because fire, a lifeless object, but works actively. As an example, smoke pollutes air. There is no life in smoke, but it actively pollutes air. So the sentence is written in active voice, and the sentence is in present indefinite tense. I will make you more clear. If I go to the next point, number 10, if you find it in the position of a subject, then you will also try to make the sentence in passive voice, because it is a pronoun and it is the pronoun of a lifeless object. The duster, its pronoun is it. The board, its pronoun is it. The pen, its pronoun is it. So when you find it, and if you get these verbs after it, you will surely make the sentence in passive form. The verbs are use, say, speak, know, consider, regard, call, learn, believe. Of course, these sentences should be written in passive form. If you get these verbs after it or any lifeless object, you will make the sentence in passive form. It use, the answer should be it is used. It say, it is said. It speak, it is spoken. It know, it is known. It consider, it is considered. It regard, it is regarded. It call, it is called. It learn, it is learned. It believe, it is believed. So when you find any lifeless object in the position of a subject, or it in the position of a subject, you will make the sentence in passive form. I think you have understood the 10 points I have discussed today. And in the previous class, I discussed 10 points. Today, I discussed 10 points. You have got 20 points for filling the gaps effectively. I think you will memorize the points, and keeping these rules in your mind, you will do the filling the gaps, and I think you will do filling the gaps easily and correctly. So dear students, if you want to get more videos on lecture, then keep your open eyes, and if you want to get these lectures in your timeline, then share it. Thank you very much.